Saint Anne was the patron saint of the explorers, of the French explorers that came to this area. We trace our founding back to 1701 when the city of Detroit itself started as Fort Pontchartrain, downtown Detroit. Well, this St. Anne building is the eighth St. Anne structure. The first six were part of Fort Pontchartrain. The seventh one, that was called the Stone Church, and that was over at Larned and Bates Streets. So this is a neo-Gothic architecture style. When you walk in here, your eyes are immediately drawn up, like you're drawn up to heaven. Everything has a point. The pews have a point. All the archways have a point. All our stained glass windows come up to a point. And of course, Jesus is alive in the tabernacle. So this is heaven on earth.
In a few days, I will read a personal letter from the Archbishop to St. Anne's Parish to announce that our church has become a basilica. I think will be received with great excitement from all the parishioners in our parish. And I think especially for our parishioners who have been here for most of their lives, you know, for decades, and they've seen the parish, you know, go through its, you know, joys and challenges, that this would be a great affirmation to understand the significance of a church like St. Anne's being named by the Holy Father, a basilica. There are around 17,000 Catholic churches in the United States. Only 85 are basilicas. The parish certainly has had a rich, diverse history over the last 319 years, but certainly becoming a basilica is a crowning of that. In a lot of ways, this is, in the history of the parish, this is going to be a real turning point. It's not just about us as a parish. It's about how we as a parish will serve the rest of the archdiocese.
St. Anne has been the anchor in this neighborhood through all those changes. This is a thing that hasn't changed. St. Anne is our grandma, right? She's Jesus' grandma. So who doesn't feel good when they go to grandma's house, you know?